To discuss this and some of the broader implications, I'm joined by Liberal Senator for New South Wales, Connie Fierravanti-Wells. Good to talk to you again, Connie. This is extraordinary. The trashing of the presumption of innocence. Anyone could understand Christian Porter walking away from politics, but my God, for the good of the country, he needs to stand his ground on this, doesn't he?
Well, the rule of law must prevail, and the presumption of innocence should be afforded to Christian Porter. It is the basic tenet of our legal system. Just like the presumption of innocence should have been afforded to Cardinal Pell and wasn't, and just like the presumption of innocence should have been afforded to our SAS soldiers following the release of the Brereton report, the presumption of innocence is very important in our legal system and should be afforded to any Australian before the law. And so, therefore, now, of course, Christian Porter has commenced defamation proceedings and against the ABC. And, of course, in doing so, it will enable him to clarify the legal issues at play here. But can I take you back to some of the comments that you also made?
Yeah, let's not forget. I want to come back to that in just a moment. But just while you're on that point, the argument putting forward here, that the ABC and others are putting forward here, is that if the Attorney General defends himself and his reputation through defamation action, that means he can't do his job anymore. So they put up sort of allegations that are very unclear and have no status. Yet his very attempt to defend himself, they say, should see him disqualified from his job.
Well, Chris, any Australian is entitled to bring defamation actions, and Christian Porter, and this is a matter, of course, for the Prime Minister and Christian Porter to define the parameters of the work that he will continue to do. There is an acting minister, and that acting minister is Michaela Cash, who is acting in that position. The point that I wanted to also focus on, picking up some of the things that you said earlier, I mean, let's not forget that there are two important issues here. One is that the New South Wales police have investigated matters and found that there was insufficient admissible evidence. But also, now the South Australian coroner has asked for an investigation of the matters. He will then consider, once the police have finished their investigations, whether he will undertake a coronial inquiry. And that, Chris, leave everything aside, that is where the matter should go. And so we should now leave the South Australian coroner to undertake his work following the investigation by the police.
Right. Now, the other issue that I raised was the treatment of Nicole Flint, the effective victim shaming that she's been subjected to for daring to raise the sexist abuse and intimidation that came her way.
Well, Chris, you and I discussed the very issue about Get Up and what was happening both to Nicole Flint and, of course, to Tony Abbott, because in July 2019, after the election, and we discussed the appalling behaviour of Get Up, both in the case of Nicole Flint and Warringah, and I had worked on that campaign, and you might recall our discussion at that time. But in relation to Nicole Flint, after the election, the Joint Standing Committee on Electoral Matters has an inquiry. And during the course of that inquiry, Nicole Flint put in a submission, as did a whole lot of other people. Her submission was very clear. It was clearly targeted at the unions, at the ALP, and at GetUp. And indeed, the evidence that was before JSCEM on that occasion was so bad that it recommended that there be an additional offence inserted into the Electoral Act, which was electoral violence. So she brought this matter to their attention. And I have to say, where were the Labor women at the time? Where was Tanya Plibersek? Where were the other women? She was the deputy leader. What, they didn't know what was going on in South Australia? Did they follow the basic tenet of Graham Richardson, whatever it takes, and then let GetUp do the dirty work, and the ALP took the advantage of the dirty work that they were doing out on the ground?
That is spot on. I mean, it's not something that's come up recently. She raised all this years ago, post-election. I just need to very briefly get your thoughts on the culture of Parliament House. There's a review going on, more revelations on one of the commercial television stations today about more sexual antics inside the building. Is it a toxic environment, particularly for women?
Well, it's always been a very difficult environment, Chris, and you've worked in this place, so you know. This should be the model workplace, but regrettably it is not. Now, we know that there are a number of inquiries that are now happening, and we heard evidence today from Commissioner Kershaw and also some evidence at estimates in relation to what's happening with the Gaitchens investigation. The bottom line, though, is what is important is that all the facts be known. We do not want any perception whatsoever that there is any cover-up in any way, shape or form. And you have to balance that against the fact that there are now investigations taking place. I mean, the Higgins matter itself is before the AFP. And today, the AFP commissioner indicated that there were 32 separate referrals which have now resulted in six matters before the AFP.
Indeed, indeed. There's a lot going on here. Thanks for talking to us, Connie. We'll catch you
again. Chris.
Connie Fierravanti-Wells there, who's a Liberal Senator for New South Wales. Now,